Maybe she hasn't rung because she's still thinking about it.
One of us should phone and see whether she's made up her mind yet. And then she can stop worrying about whether I want her to foster me or not. And then she can get on with deciding that she does.
Tracy, you can't force people into making a decision about something that's as life-changing as fostering a child.
But it's my life that should be changing. And every day it doesn't is one more dumping ground day of stressful, agonising suffering. I can't sleep. And I've gone right off my food. It's awful. Nothing looks right or tastes right anymore.
Who was the last one?
Honestly, Jenny, I'm practically wasting away, look!
Tracy, that's terrible. Hope you asked before you borrowed Ryan's trousers.
Start stealing other people's trousers. Oh, quick, ring Cal before I get any worse.
10 out of 10 for effort, but it's a definite 0 on the phone call.
I knew you wouldn't understand the pain I'm going through. I can't believe they put a mean old trout like you in charge of a children's home.
Yo, Beaker. Whoa, major mood alert.
Jenny won't let me ring Cam to see if she's going to foster me.
I'm not surprised. I wouldn't like to have a chat like that over the phone.
You got a bus fare?
Why?
Because we're going to Cannes, of course.
Beaker, wait! Don't you think we should...
Never interrupt me when I'm planning campaign, Ben. So, listen up, soldier. I want this operation to run like clockwork.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, give me a break, girls. I don't need reminding what state my poor, neglected car's in.
I think it's time we made this car feel loved and wanted. Come on.
It must be weird not having a mum.
I've got a mum.
Yeah, I know. It must do your head in, not knowing where she is.
I know exactly where she is.
She's on a top-secret mission to make first contact with aliens on the most distant planets that only the President and my mum even know about. It can be very frightening. You need really long training to be good at that kind of work. I know she's out there somewhere. And wherever she is, she'll be looking after people. Because that's the sort of kind, life-saving person my mum is.
Quick, Tracy, it hurts!
Here you go, Mum. Mm. It's OK. Oh. It's all better now.
If you've got a mum, then what do you need Cam for?
To take care of me and spoil me until she gets back, of course. Jenny, please.
Girls, I'm begging for mercy here. Can we please change the subject?
But Jenny, a fiver's nothing to have a really nice clean car. And you're getting a bargain, because it's only a fiver and there's two of us. So you'll get a car twice as clean for half the money. And you don't want people pointing and saying...
I submit, you can do it.
Yes.
Changing some old clothes first.
At least you can get your work done now.
Frankly, I'd rather lick the car clean.
Then you say...
Cam, why don't you grab the opportunity of having a ready-made child and foster Tracy?
Then I say, That way you get a kid without going through all the scratchy business of changing nappies and getting up in the middle of the night. Cam realises it's a brilliant idea. Hugs and kisses all around and Tracy Beaker's fostered.
I don't think she's going to go for this.
Trust me, it's going to be a wrapped up, snapped up deal.
Clean me. Zach!
I told you we should have rang first.
Bet there's a spare key somewhere.
Come on.
I knew it.
Beaker!
Oh, don't be such a wuss. She's practically my mother. Welcome to my new home.
So it's only a fiver for both of us. That's an absolute bargain for such a filthy car.
It's not the money, Ryan. I've already told Justine and Louise that they can do it.
But we thought of it too.
But they beat you in here.
That is so unfair.
You can do it next month, okay?
That is 4 whole weeks away.
Yep. Do you want to help me with some paperwork to pass the time away?
It's a good job I'm moving in. Cam hasn't got a clue. This place looks like a right dump. But I'll soon have it sorted. It just needs some clever changes. Like that. And this. And that. Well, don't you just stand there. This is in completely the wrong place to watch TV. Ryan, shove off. We were here first. Jenny! Jenny!
Back off, boys, or Justine and Louise get to clean the car next month as well.
Beaker haven't just started yet.
Chocolates are supposed to be eaten, they'll only go off.
If Cam's not back here by the end of this CD, we're going.
We're staying till she gets here. Look at all the work we've done. Unless she wanna thank us. I have to celebrate you, baby. I have to praise you like I should. I have to praise you. I have to praise you. Tracy! How on earth did you get in?
Right, you turn it on and I'll get the soap off.
Okay.
Empty my fridge, help yourself to my chocolates, and play my CDs at full blast.
The only way we could bear to listen to them, you've got rubbish CDs.
Oh, well, I'll try and lay on something better for next time you break in.
We're sorry, Cam.
At least he's got the decency to apologise.
You're the one who should apologise. I thought you'd be thrilled to find me here, but you spoil everything. You ungrateful cow. I must have been mad to want you as my foster mum.
Tracy. I have never said I would be your foster mum.
Come on, Ben. I'm not staying where I'm not wanted.
Oh, no, you don't. I'm taking you back so I can have a word with Jenny. And I'll drop you off on the way.
They are going to pay for this.
Thank you.
angry grown-up face on.
I'm not angry anymore, Tracy, but I am concerned about what you did.
And I bet you're going to share that concern with Jenny.
Do you want us to wash your car for you? It's only a fiver.
Oh, no thanks. I think the shock would kill it.
And you must know how wrong it is to break into someone's flat without permission.
I didn't break in. I used a key.
You may have used a key, Tracy, but you didn't have permission. Now, behaviour like that is totally unacceptable and I will not tolerate it under any circumstances.
Were we ever in the right place at the right time? Fancy getting two cars to wash in one day.
If there's another car to wash, it's mine and Zach's.
You wish. Me and Louise will do it.
You got Jenny's car, we get this one. Too right.
If you're really gonna go on, help yourself.
Yes!
I'm sorry, cab. I only did it because I wanted to see you.
I know. Just don't do it again, eh?
Okay, Tracy, you can go now.
Oh, I wonder when you get to that bit where you sent me off so you could talk about me. Well, just remember, I'm a victim of my tragic past, which I could easily put behind me if I had a loving and stable home.
Yeah. Well, aren't you going to do the inside then?
Oh, right. Thanks.
I knew you'd go without saying goodbye.
Tracy.
I don't care. It's not my fault I've got behavioural problems. I should have known you'd never stick it out and foster me.
Look, I'd never leave you without saying goodbye, Tracy, ever, okay? And I'm not saying I won't foster you.
What?
I'm just not saying that I will.
That means you're going to, right?
Wrong. It means, if you promise never to break into my flat again, that I'm still thinking about it.
Looks good, eh? Worth a fiver of anyone's money.
Well, sorry, boys. I hate having a clean car. It shows all the rust. Otherwise, I'd let Justine and Louise do it when they asked me.
What?
Nobody soaks my possible maybe. Still thinking about it, foster mum and gets away with it.
Yeah, Tracy, look. Get him!